Ndingisoni mutimamu.
Ndingisoni mutimamu.
Ndingisoni mutimamu. Bona Kristu, zoma kujira batigori. Ngakaya magota alikujira. Ngakaya upiri alikujira.
My name is John Eckstead. I am an ordained minister of the Lutheran Church. I have also served as a government administrator and university professor. From all of these perspectives and pursuits, I have had opportunity to participate in and organize various projects. Some of them have been international in scope. This path has brought me to the place I am today, having been given the privilege to represent in a small way some people from another place and another way of life.
I gotcha.
By way of these images and these sounds, especially the singing, the people of the village of Mgona in the Nsanje District of Malawi send you greetings. These people are members and friends of the Hope Christian Mission established in 2015 as a collaboration between Christians in the community of Mgona and supporters from various locations in Canada and the United States. The people of Mgona are mostly members of the Sina and Chiwa tribes of the African Bantu Nation. The official languages spoken are Chichewa and English. The village of Mgona is in the southeast corner of the country of Malawi, along the banks of the Shiri River that is the border with Mozambique. The territory or parish served by the Hope Christian Mission includes villages on both sides of the Shiri River, giving the congregation a presence in both Malawi and Mozambique. Among these people, I am known as Pastor John. I, in turn, refer to my closest collaborator in the village as Pastor Stephen.
Today we are dedicating our church. We will dedicate our church in the name of God.
I have lived and worked for many years in cross-cultural settings where people are suffering from some form of social or economic disadvantage. This work has normally required that a priority be given to community development and emergency aid support before more substantial or self-sustaining community improvements can begin. Our practices have always been guided by a faith perspective, with its emphasis on spiritual well-being. We have balanced this with the persistent pursuit of the best tools and skills that modern science and technology has to offer. From the perspective of our faith, both Pastor Stephen and I see the world and the human interactions within it as a reflection of the relationship between God the Creator and the creation of which we are a part. We see this relationship as broken and in need of healing. The poor and needy are among us as evidence of this brokenness. Our duty as we see it is to respond to the needs of the broken and address conditions of poverty and disadvantage, using the wisdom that God gives us and the knowledge acquired through the best of human endeavor.
But it is also a special day for the churches around the world.
The opportunity to organize ourselves in assistance to the people of Mgona came in an email from Pastor Stephen to myself in the summer of 2015. I had written a sermon earlier that had been distributed internationally by the Ecumenical Advocacy Alliance in Geneva, Switzerland. It was based on the text from Isaiah 58:10 that reads, "And if you spend yourselves in behalf of the hungry and satisfy the needs of the oppressed, then your light will rise in the darkness and your night become like the noonday." It was from these sentiments that the circle of faith turned and a decision was taken to open a mission in the village of Mgona, Malawi. As planning evolved, it was determined that the mission would include a church, an experimental garden, and a medical health center. To understand this project, it is important to note that I, Pastor John, have not been to Malawi. For me, this has been a cyber project with all arrangements and communications handled electronically or through various messengers. These messengers have included agricultural specialists from the United States who have visited the gardens and provided helpful instruction. Pastor John's brother Richard, a clinical specialist and former hospital administrator, has developed much of the material for the medical program. Pastor Davis Wuwa and his congregation from Mazuzu in the northern part of Malawi have provided invaluable assistance. But perhaps the messengers with the most recent familiarity and knowledge of the people and the place are the two men who made this documentary. They are Stephen Nelson from Alberta, Canada, and Dean Karalikas from New York City in the United States. These men began their visit to Mgona and started recording for the documentary at the time a celebration was taking place to dedicate the completed church and gardens while also breaking ground for the planned medical center. Thank you. The people named this celebration the Festival of Pentecost, and they used it to recall the circumstances surrounding the very beginnings of the Christian Church. This festival brought together people from Malawi and Mozambique to proclaim their commitment of service to each other in the spirit of their common faith. The work of Pastor Stephen and the trustees of the Hope Christian Mission has been truly commendable. They have done a magnificent job under difficult and trying circumstances. However, all of us agree that we should make particular mention of the contribution of the main village administrator or headman at the time we began this project. Her name was Narayi Gautsini. At the time of our arrival, the head man was a head woman. This was a very unusual and unique feature of the village when we entered it and influenced all our decision making. The wisdom and active presence of this woman set precedents and provided examples affecting the mission at Mgona as well as in other communities of the region. Several aid agencies working in that part of Malawi sought her advice and followed her direction. Our activities in the present and our vision for the future is based largely on one exchange between myself, Pastor John, and the head woman during the very early days of the project. From these communications, three founding principles emerged to which we have tried to remain faithful. The first is that we will do nothing in our work to disrupt or interfere with the general administration of the Mgona village as exercised through its elected or appointed chiefs. The second is that all our decisions be directed to the eventual self-administration of the mission by its trustees and elected officers, and that all programs, such as the church, the gardens, and the medical center, become self-sustaining. The third is to always have in mind the nurturing of the children, and especially the girls. These were matters that were dear to the heart of this good and gracious woman, Nayari Galsini.
I love you.
I love you.
I love you.
All
you
need
is
love.
Love.
All
you
need
is
love.
Love.
All you need
is love.
We have dedicated ourselves to remain faithful to these principles as long as we are allowed to be a presence among her people. And we dedicate this documentary to her and to the children of the village of Mgona, who are its future. It is my hope that this presentation will be a blessing to you as you share a moment with these people in their place.
I love you.
I love you.
I love you.
I love you. I love you.